always find people who are helping. The ever affable Mr. Rogers.
Aha. He quoted Mr. Rogers from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. That's fire. No way. Cap is gonna fight Rogue.
Excuse my bright eyes and stuffy voice on top of it being like super early in the morning, but allergies are really getting to me. So I hope this episode is godlike. And if you didn't catch the joke, that's the episode title's name. Yeah. Bright eyes. Let's get into it. Obviously on X-Men. Ooh, it's a Rogue episode. I don't even remember if I said that. It might have been last week. Dancing, drinking wine, making love. He really said they were making love and referred back to that scene. That's crazy. I love these intros. So far, this is very similar and identical to last week's. I haven't noticed any new shots yet. Oh, maybe that one with the bishop? Or did we see that, I think? I feel like we saw that one. That Cyclops one might be new. Everything else is the same. Man. They really gotta start us with this. Ugh, this is terrible. Damn, they even got Nightcrawler as the "we are gathered here today" type shit. Is that his crew? I recognize those guys. This is, I didn't want the episode to start like this, bro. This is terrible. Yeah, I was about to say, where's Rogue? All right, don't tell me this is Savage Land. Oh, shit. It's Rogue, though. Oh, she's not playing. This is a Rogue episode. Oh, whoa. She got rider kicks. Oh, she's mad. Ross? Holy shit. Oh, my God. Ooh. Wow. Holy shit, there's no... What? Not a single survivor out of that? This is the first time we're seeing Gina Scott back in action. Wow. This show is way too good, bro. I'm sorry, but this shit is the best. Oh, wow, I saw a blob. Always find people who are helping. The ever affable Mr. Rogers. Haha. He quoted Mr. Rogers from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. That's fire. No way. Cap is gonna fight Rogue. I thought he was trapped. What happened? He got out. Her holding that shield is kind of crazy. Your team? Gotta do this by the book, Rogue. Right now, my hands are tied. Oh boy. She threw away his shield. Wow. We thought that Cap was about to be more involved. Strong guy. Don't want them burying a stranger. Ooh, that's a good point. Wow. Leech is dead. Riots are the language of the unheard. Martin Luther King. My man Beast is quoting MLK. Oh. Was you reporting outside my home while my friends were dying? Ooh. Got him. I dare not waste any more of your tolerance, Miss Tilby. Damn, Beast ain't having no time. Oh, there he is. Oh, he's expecting her. I hope she's okay doing this. What was that? Jesus. A telepath? Was it White Queen? Oh, yes, it is. Oh, her diamond transformation just triggered. Under pressure. That's definitely a diamond type of reference. Wow, so I guess that means Madeline's dead. Trask created Master Mold, i.e. all of this is literally his fault, i.e. we can't trust him. So now they're going to Madripoor. What the heck? Yeah, but Jubilee and Sunspot went all the way back to where his family's from? In the middle of all this? That's kind of crazy. I'm a mutant. Oh, that didn't go well. She downed the whole John. Your father and I agreed. It was your secret to tell. Oh, thank God. Oh, that's beautiful. Making sure we keep this all private. What? Wow. Baby steps, I guess. Is it the Dia de los Muertos? Magneto to be killed. Wow, so Magneto's presumed dead. Yet you nearly ruined it. Is Bastion? I have heard about this guy. He's crazy. Wow, look at all those bodies. All those AI units. Why do those look like Ultrons? They're trying to build the Nimrods. These cases light years ahead of ours. Yeah. It's probably Bastion because he's for the future. I have nothing. Same sugar. What? Nah, someone's gonna have to go save this dude. Holy shit, she let him die! Vogue, what have you done? What we all wanted to do. Wow. Bro. Dark Rogue. I love to see it. Whoa, what? Was he a fucking... No way. Prime Sentinel. Wow, so he wasn't dead after all. Or maybe he was. I don't know. Wow, that was awesome. Prime Bolivar. Whoa! Quicksilver! Where the hell did he come from? Oh, that was Morph. Damn. I got so excited. Morph gets us every time. What the hell? Is that definitely future tech? That's gotta be Cable. Come on. Come on. Yes! You're not her. Oh my god. Wow. The reunion, Dad. Oh, shit. Man. Don't stop him. There won't be much of a future worth living in. Holy shit. Damn. Oh, he knows about Xavier coming back. Holy shit. Is that Magnus? Is he shaving him? Bro, why is he shaving him? Dude, what the hell is going on? Wow, another banger. I don't even know, bro. All I do know is that next week is the start of the three-part special that's going to lead to this epic finale. And now we can officially confirm that it is Bastion that is the big bad threat. And it's actually not Apocalypse. That was somewhat of a swerve. I don't know if he's going to actually play a part in all of this, but Bastion, from what I am aware of, is pretty freaking insane. So I looked him up on Wiki, and I'm going to read you guys exactly who this dude is before we go. Bastion is a mysterious man named Sebastian Gilberti who had risen to power in a relatively short time in the U.S. government and began assembling the International Anti-Mutant Strike Force Operation Zero Tolerance. And if you notice, the episodes that we're about to get is literally called Tolerance is Extinction. It all connects. When the X-Men learned about the existence of OZT some months before the operation became public, Gambit and Phoenix, acting on information, snuck into an OZT meeting being held at a Pentagon to learn more about the program and its leader, Bastion, but did not come out with much. Bastion showed that he was more than met the eye, as Phoenix could not read his mind, and Bastion easily identified the two X-Men hidden among representatives of various foreign intelligence agencies interested in supporting OZT. I just had to read ahead so I can see exactly like what I should be telling you guys, so we know exactly what we're dealing with here. So this is a part of his origin. While in government custody, more mysteries surrounding Bastion were discovered, but before further investigation could be made, Bastion managed to escape and return to the home of his mother figure, Rose Gilberti. However, she is accidentally killed by the authorities, which sends Bastion into a rage and returns to the former OZT facility, where Cable is fighting Machine Man, who has lost touch with his humanity. Bastion makes contact with the Master Mold unit, which he had created, the Prime Sentinels. Master Mold is drained of its energy as Bastion is transformed into a Nimrod unit. So being transformed allowed Bastion's memories to be unblocked in the process, and as it turns out, Bastion had not been born human at all, but started life out as two separate beings, the Sentinel Master Mold and the highly advanced Sentinel Nimrod from an alternate future. So while posing as a human construction worker, Nimrod unearthed a module from Master Mold. As soon as Nimrod made physical contact with the module, Master Mold's programming began to co-opt Nimrod. Shortly after, during a conflict with the X-Men, the two of them, along with the X-Men Rogue, were blasted through the siege Perilous, a mystical creature capable of judging any who pass through it and reincarnating them into a new life commensurate in quality with their previous life. It was the Siege Perilous that was responsible for merging Nimrod and Master Mold into a single being with no memory of his past. All right, that's all I'm going to read. Just so you get the idea, this guy is insane. Much like this episode, I can't believe like this is the timeline we're living in. But yeah, episode 7 was fire. I can't wait for next week. I'm still stuffy. So I hope you guys have a better day than me. Bye.